Okay. Well, thank you for sharing that, Mr. Gupta. Coming on to the financial industry, right? So, my question is, how big is this industry in India? I know, of course, it's a very big industry, but if you had to put a number to it.
So you come to the, I mean, it's a more of our entertainment in current scenario. So we sell, the India sell around 1.5 billion ticket every year. And we are selling around 70 million tickets every year in the company. And so we in a multiplex sector, we hold around 25% market share. I mean, we don't really count as a competition to a single screen because that business is altogether different.
Different, absolutely. So what stage do you think India is currently in from the financial perspective?
India, as I told you, we have a huge growth scope in the country as of now, and we feel that in next couple of years, or one decade, I can say we are definitely growing very fast, right. And there is a huge demand across as a finance profession as well as the entertainment business. So strongly, I would recommend that as a finance person to look at this kind of industry, especially entertainment. Which has a huge demand of the manpower, but have a patience to stay with the business, with the company or the organization.
Okay, so how do you think we can go from looking at innovations like AI, machine learning as a partner and not as a threat?
Inox is getting for last four years, Inox is getting the most innovation award on IT side. And it is from the Retail Forum of India, it is from the Cine Expo, which is the platform for all the cinema industry. Why? Because we are the one who has pioneered in the cinema space. We launched recently something called the Screen X, which is basically 270 degree viewing angle. It means you have three screens, on a cinema, and you will suddenly find a bike is moving from this side to that side. That is first in India to launch with. We were first to launch in Maharashtra the LED screen, where you don't need projectors now. It's a big TV or LED screens where you are watching the movie. The good part about it, your sharpness and focus is huge. So you don't need to dim the light also, and you can watch the movie. So a lot of technological innovation which is happening in our industry, and we are the pioneer in the industry in terms of adopting the technology very fast.
What do you think are the key challenges of this industry?
The key challenge, one is the content availability. So there is a huge, in particular year, we suddenly see a huge content which are coming up, and quality content. Right. And sometimes you see a pattern is followed, and after some time people get irritated or bored from the content. So, I mean, we see that kind of interruption in the industry in terms of that. Second is technology, the way it is evolving right now. So we have seen VCR days, we have seen the single screens running, the television was launched 20 years back, OTT, which is one of the bigger platforms which are coming up right now. Still, the experience on cinema is very different, and people come to the cinema because of the experience which they feel they will get in the cinema theater, not on a small screen or your mobile. But you don't know what is next. Maybe in 10 years something will further change. That's why it is important for us to keep a pace with it and maintain and change ourselves with the technology. Third part is, I would say, is the regulation. As I told you, regulation is a big threat, because it's changing very fast. And being in 17 states of this country, I mean, whenever a political change happen in the state, you feel a lot of trouble on ground. Right. A simple example today I can give you, in our cinema, on a 7 days, you feel that there will be some 60% occupancy or 80% occupancy are there on a weekend, which is typically a Saturday, Sunday. But for first 5 days, you don't see much of people. Today, your regulation don't have a flexibility where you can engage or employ somebody only for weekends, not for the weekdays. You have to employ one person throughout the month. If we have that kind of flexibility where you can employ somebody, then probably we can save a lot of cost. As I told you earlier, we need to get license to run a cinema, 11 licenses. You need to go to traffic, you need to traffic police, to a normal police station, local municipal corporation, to the fire department, to the PWD, to the collector office. You need all these permission to run a cinema.
That is very cumbersome.
Yeah, so it has all its own challenges. While things has got digitized over the past few years, I think the government has to also change their pace and the way they are allowing the multiplex to grow, because it's the biggest employment generator in the nearby location, where you engage 70 to 100 people in every location.
True.
And normally we engage all the people who are normally residing in 3 to 5 kilometer vicinity. We don't choose a person from outside, because you need a very normal usual skills. You don't need expertise for everything. I mean, there are a couple of jobs will be expertise, but not every job.
Interesting. How do you think the startup ecosystem is changing the landscape of the industry?
Startup is coming on all the field, but fortunately for us, the while a lot of technology are changing inside the cinema, the startup cannot come in the cinema field. While we have heard about couple of formats where like running or moving cinema, on a wheels, but it has not got success the way it should be, so it will take time. In our field, it is less of a competition, but of course, you have to keep upgrading with the technology every time.
True. Talking about manpower, what do you think are the challenges the industry currently faces, and what factors need immediate action?
One is the retention. So as I told you, is industry engage, a person who is doing a very basic work, right from security to housekeeping to a very expert job of running an IT system. So different wage level, of course, and every state has a different rule for wages. This is something called the minimum wages. The challenge is, in a particular state you are getting X, and in the next state you are getting double X. Mm-hmm. And suddenly the rule changes in one state to another.
Right.
So one is the wages level is such a fluctuating level where industry is not able to cope up, because you have a very high fees, high fixed cost structure in a cinema, which you have to keep engaging with 70 people continuous basis. Second is rentals are growing up like anything. Your electricity consumptions rates are going up day in day out. So a fixed cost structure is very high, where your revenue model is not fixed, because this is based on the movie. A movie can do a 300 crore and movie cannot do a 50 crore also. So it all depends, on the choice of the viewers.
Yes, true. What is your suggestion to mid-career people in the financial industry?
It's a very exciting industry, and people nowadays, if you ask me, it gives you not only the job and of course the earnings, it also gives you a lot of touch and feel in this business. Because being a part of this industry, I strongly feel that people enjoy their job. If you are enjoying your job and also doing your job, making your money, I think that's the best industry to be within. And you get a lot of flexibility in workings. You get flexi hours. The pressure is not much high, if you ask me, compared to the manufacturing industry I've seen.